Hey, so this is Alex here with the Nunez Insurance Agency, and I wanted to actually go through some information that I've learned about the stabilization loan program that is available to businesses in LA County that have gone through any kind of hardship due to COVID-19 shutdowns and restrictions. So let me go into this. This is a new program that has been recently funded, and there is a deadline for applications to be submitted by April 16th, 2021. So I wanted to really create this video, and if you could actually share it to any business owners you know that are in the LA County area. And that would be extremely valuable. The main thing here is that we want to let as many people know about this program before the April 16th cutoff date so that they're at least in the running for this loan. And interesting enough, there is a lot of this is not really well publicized, and there's just not a lot of people that are applying for this. I actually called and talked to some of the loan reps there, and they are still accepting applications. One thing too that you want to note on this is that just because that they have a certain cutoff, April 16th, doesn't mean that it won't there won't be another window to apply, but you want to get your application in now because if you notice here it says or the total of 20 million loan request is received. So I guarantee you they're going to be releasing more funds. They're actually going to be probably providing even more funds, especially in LA County, because it's one of the hardest hit counties really in California. The shutdowns have been extremely severe and a lot longer than anywhere else in the country, and at least we're in the top 10 or something like that. So there's going to be a lot of relief for businesses, so you want to be kind of aware of all these programs, and there will be coming, and we just want to keep businesses in these areas informed about these programs because they're not always finding out about it. So that being said, let me actually go through some general information about the program, how to apply and go through the process, everything really you need to know to get started. So first and foremost, the website that you want to know is this website here on top of my browser that you'll see here, which is bizstabilization.lacda.org. And right here, you're going to see kind of all the information that you're going to need to know. We have prepare to submit, receive. So here's a basic overview. I have some general notes here on the left column here, but basically, let me go through the website, which mostly has everything you need to know. So, Small Business Stabilization Loan Program, the Los Angeles County Development Authority has launched an affordable and flexible business loan program to support and help stabilize businesses in the region. Small business stabilization loan ranges from $50,000 to $3 million, which, if you think about it, that's kind of ridiculous because they say here the total is 20 million in loan request is received. So guaranteed, they're actually going to have way more funds available for this program than 20 million. So I almost wonder if that's a typo, to be honest with you, because there's definitely a lot more stabilization loan needed. But this is one of the main programs available to Los Angeles County. So whatever don't waste your don't delay basically on these kind of numbers here, or definitely on the date they'll probably cut you off, but you definitely want to start applying. And the loans, typically, I have learned some information about these programs that I want to share with you too, some more kind of to kind of help speed up the process for you. So, eligibility, business must be physically located within Los Angeles County. Businesses must have been operating for a minimum of 2 years at the time of the application. For a list of ineligible businesses, click here. Typically, all the ineligible businesses are pretty common to most of the relief programs out there, so you'll probably click here and not be surprised. But interest rate, fixed Wall Street Journal prime rate. So again, you're going to have a pretty low rate if you get this loan, and you're going to have long-term working capital, equipment, real estate acquisition, and construction up to 20 years. Important loan application will be accepted until April 16th or until the total funds request is received, whichever comes first. Step one is applying for an affordable, flexible LACDA loan webinar to learn more about the requirements of the application program process and documentation needed. So the way this works is you're not going to just fill out an application and then apply, right? What you have to do, what they want you to do, is actually do a webinar. And the webinar is basically filter out, I guess, I don't know if it's actually not to filter out, but mostly to prepare you for the loan application process, to make sure you have everything in order to apply. Basically, this is hopefully their intention, I think, with this is to give you the best chances of getting the loan. So it's actually a very interesting thing they're doing. And actually, I have a breakdown PDF that I put together on what to expect on your webinar. So basically, this is a webinar to learn more about the requirements of the application process, but you actually want to prepare for the actual webinar. So which you'll probably, as you click through, you'll learn what some of the things that they're going to look at, but I'm just kind of giving you a little bit insight right now in this video. So for the webinar, outline is going to be as follows. What is Small Business Stabilization Loan Program? Business requirements, loan details, use of funds, collateral, process of application. The value for this that is the real value for this meeting is how many times you apply for, spend all this time applying for some program or grant or anything and get denied. And you're like, why don't you just tell me up front? Why did I spend all this freaking time and I didn't? That's probably got to be the most, especially now when business owners just don't have time to be like submitting all these loan applications. So I think it's actually valuable that they're doing this, which is basically preparing you and helping you fill out the application to give you the best chances of getting the actual loan. And so I think that's a huge, huge benefit. So use of funds, collateral, process of application. Businesses have to be located in Los Angeles County, which is a given. This is the Los Angeles County Small Business Stabilization Loan. Businesses must be in operation for at least 2 years, evidenced by ITR. And then company must be in good standing at California businesses. So definitely want to look up your business to make sure you're in good standing. So here's the website for that. And all information in the webinar came from below website. Yep. Additional notes. This is the website we're going through right now, actually. Additional notes. If the loan will be used for purchase inventory equipment, the loan amount will be distributed directly to the vendors. Hard pull credit report is required. Minimum FICO score of 620 is a must. Not needed to report a profit in previous years. So again, remember, they're going through this in the webinar. So if you're not sure about your credit, usually what they're probably going to do is have you down. They're not going to do a hard pull on the webinar. Remember, this is just a webinar. It's a consultation that LA County has hired this firm to consult you on the application process. Okay, so basically, what's going to happen here is, prior to the webinar date, you're going to have a scheduled date, and they're going to go ahead and give you, or they're going to request some documents. And part of that is probably they want a PDF of your credit report. So you can go to any of the credit bureaus and download a PDF copy of your credit report, and they'll probably want to see that. And that will be used to help advise you. I think they use Experian. I'm actually positive they're going to use Experian credit reports. So you're going to want to use that or can have at least access to your Experian credit report if you don't. Not needed to report a profit in previous years. So only required a stable income. So this is a key thing right here. So what they're saying here is some of the other loans and relief programs out there, they are going to want to see a profit that you've, your business has been profitable to some degree. In this case, that's not what's needed. Your business does not have to show a profit. What it just needs to show stable income. So that's very important to know. The ability to pay of the owners will be taken into consideration. The loan will be reported on your personal credit report. Again, this is just the points, additional notes that about the application process. So they'll probably be going through these notes with you in the consultation webinar that you're doing. The webinar is, again, going to just go through all these points. It is advised that all requirements should be prepared before the one-on-one counseling so that the counselor can review the documents. I think what happens is that you complete the webinar, and the webinar is going to just go through these points with you. And then afterwards, step two is that you're going to actually kind of confirm that you're going to actually have a certificate saying that you completed the webinar, that which is then going to allow you to set up a one-on-one counseling session. The one-on-one counseling session is where they're going to start requesting documents. Okay. Documents is just so that they can, so after the webinar is done, you're going to have the one-on-one session. So again, let me finish these steps here. It is advised that all requirements should be prepared before the one-on-one counseling. Yes. There's no exact computation of the loan amount. It is advised to request a loan amount based on the revenue and previous loan applied. Loan cannot be used to pay line of credits payment, which makes sense, obviously. At least it makes sense to me. They're not going to want you to just pay a line of credit. They actually do let you, from what I've learned, consolidate some of your loans, which is might be helpful to most of the business owners as well, to provide them more capital because they'll have lower payments. Payments will be deferred for 12 months. That's a key point here. So when you get the loan, you can consolidate some debt, or you can use it as working capital, and you won't have payments up until 12 months. But to get more details about this, that's what will happen on your one-on-one session. So information needed for your application, type of entity, full legal name, borrower, businesses, social, tax ID, date, established, title of applicant, business, phone, home. Just normal information here. Requirements needed for to be prepared. Personal financial statements, assets, cash, hand in bank, accounts and notes, receivable, savings account. So, they're going to need basically P&Ls and a balance sheet, it sounds like. Liabilities, source of income, of course. Personal monthly budget. These are the basic questions that they're going to want filled out. And business debt schedule. Yes, that's just a normal QuickBooks report if you have it. Explanation of economic hardship due to COVID. How is your business impacted by COVID-19? What have you done to address the impact of COVID-19 on your business, i.e. pivot to pivot to add new product, online sales, outdoor dining, etc. Documents needed to provide an upload PDF signed. Basically the here explanation of economic hardship. I think it's crazy to think that no business has been affected. And this loan is definitely geared more towards businesses that have been affected negatively in some way, whether it's increased expenses or decreased revenue. So there's some businesses that have really flourished during this time. I highly doubt that this is something that they're going to be looking at. This is a documents needed to provide and upload signed business federal tax IT returns, signed personal financial tax returns for the prior 2 years. Fiscal year and businesses. Now, I'm not going to really go into the details of all these forms. This is just general information. Again, you're going to have a one-on-one. If you submit to this process, you're going to do the webinar, you're going to go to a one-on-one counseling session. All your questions are going to be answered. The questions should not be answered by me. I'm just trying to get the information out there and to be as helpful as possible so that you take action. Okay. That's my whole goal, is take action, get scheduled for the webinar, get your one-on-one counseling session, and then just get access to some pretty affordable, funds. Basically is the idea. Then we got the next step. I went into the the counseling. Step three is borrow. Borrower is referred to a technical assistance provider. Borrower will be contacted to set up one-on-one counseling session appointment. Okay, I thought this was step two. All right. Well, the website is whatever. So you have all the steps here. Main thing is to start. Now, here's some information about the loan details. Loan details: minimum $50,000, maximum $3 million. I mean, just what I've heard is that anything above $100,000 is going to require a lot more extensive underwriting loan process. So my recommendation is if you can make do with a loan of under $100,000, that would probably be the best way to go. But again, you're going to talk to your counselor about the best options for your business. Fixed Wall Street Journal prime rate, currently 3.25%. We always look at variable interest stuff, you know, because it could go way high, could go way low, but still, if this loan is cheaper than some of your other loans, use it to consolidate a portion of those loans. I mean, that will be valuable. Loan terms: working capital 5 to 7 years, equipment up to 10 years, real estate acquisitions and construction up to 20 years, loan repayment deferred for 12 months, and non-guaranteed loans interest will be anyways, you can read the details of this stuff. This is pretty interesting stuff. Origination fees: none of your loans under $100,000. So none. So that's a good thing. So no origination fees if your loan is under $100,000. That's, you know, really affordable loan. 1.5% for loans above $100,000. 2.5% for loans. Loan amounts above $250 for document processing fee for loan guarantees. Okay. Job creation: a minimum of one full-time equivalent job must be retained or created per $75,000 of loan assistance. I think it's retained. You know, so basically, as long as you're doing one of those things, you're good. Collateral is required for the purchase of equipment under $100,000. A lien is in place for equipment. A lien is placed on equipment purchased. All loans guaranteed under the Disaster Relief Loan Guarantee Program, as outlined below. All loans above $100,000. So, if your loan is under $100,000, sounds like there's no collateral that is needed. Minimum collateral coverage must be 70%, subject to review on case-by-case basis. Collateral coverage will be determined by dividing available collateral by the loan amount, collateral value, available collateral. Okay, so they'll go through this with you. Again, you'll have a counselor on this, but as far as I know, this loan is still pretty decent, especially if you're getting a loan under $100,000. Type of collateral: cash surrender value. So these are some information on the types of collateral. What you need to know: good faith deposit. All loans above $100,000 will require good faith deposit to cover all third-party costs. Application limit: only one application per legal entity will be considered for this loan program. Loan committee review: all loans above $250,000 shall be subject to review and approval by the LACDA loan committee. Disclaimer: the LACDA may revise the guidelines as needed to ensure program goals. Okay, guys, so main thing here, main message: get this started. Please forward this information to anybody that has a business in LA County so that they at least know about this program. This is one of the best programs that are available. Again, the credit rating can be low. You don't have to be profitable. Maybe they can refinance some of their use of funds here. Loan terms: did I talk about that? I think that's important to actually go into. Is, oh, you know what, I missed all these different sections here. Business owner requirements right here. So business owner requirements: good standing, must be in good active standing with Secretary of State. Click here to check your status. Absolutely. Credit check: a hard credit pull reports is required. Borrower must show good credit management with a minimum FICO score of 620. Impact statement: borrower must provide a hardship statement with an explanation of what has been done. Financial stability, ability to repay, guarantees, we went over that. Use of funds. Eligible uses: working capital, equipment, inventory, real estate acquisition, refinancing of existing loans. Loans to be refinanced must be current. So that's a big part of it, guys. If you have any loans, credit cards are included in loans that have a higher interest rate than 3.25%. You should really consider this loan. This is a good option. You know, if you have a loan that's 10% or credit cards are 15%, or this is a way to kind of get that paid down. So this is a really great option. Other requirements, Davis-Bacon related act, borrowers shall be responsible for paying off all labor, compliance, construction, inspection, okay, appraisals of automobile, automated valuation models, environmental review. Okay, so this is not applicable to everybody, but there you go. Okay, so some takeaways here. You want to go ahead and just start the process, right? If you have an accountant or somebody or an administrative person that can help you put together these documents, you want to actually start kind of preparing these documents ahead of time. So the more you have these documents ready, this process is going to be smooth going. Right, so definitely don't wait last minute when you're at that stage to prepare the documents. Just have it all ready in a file, ready to forward over when the right time to forward it comes up. So I will also include some of the links in the description and any other resources I can provide you. Feel free to comment and let me know if you have any additional questions, but really most of your questions should be handled by your doing this webinar and also doing that one-on-one counseling session. Okay, great. Thank you guys. Hope this was helpful. If it was helpful, please subscribe, like, and you know, also consider using us for any of your insurance needs. All right, bye.